give me the whole bag.
Today, we'll be looking at the LG L206WTQ Flatron widescreen monitor. Now, this is a 20.1-inch monitor, and currently, it's the black one over here. And currently, I'm running it in a dual screen, so let's say I can open up Internet Explorer on one, and then if I wanted to, I could drag it from one screen to the other and then open up another one, like so. Now, this monitor has a 3,000:1 contrast ratio and a 2-millisecond response time, which is pretty impressive. And on top of that, I got this monitor at my local Future Shop for about $200 Canadian on sale, so I think it's a pretty good deal that I got. Here is the box for the monitor, and as you can see, it's a pretty decent sized box. Here are some labels for the monitor. It's Windows Vista certified, has 2-millisecond response time, and of course it's Energy Star compliant, which is good, you know, good for the environment. And on the top here, you'll see a sturdy handle for you to carry it. And as you open the top here, the first thing you'll see is a vague easy setup guide, which you really don't need. You just gotta plug in the cable, your DVI or your VGA, and you're ready to go. Of course, here it comes with drivers for the special functions that it has, but I'll explain that later in the video. And of course, nice to see good styrofoam packaging here. And of course, more bags inside. Now, the one thing about this monitor I'm not really sure about that I like is that it only comes with a VGA cable. So if you're planning to run DVI like I am, you'll have to either get another, purchase another cable like that or so. It only comes with a VGA cable. Now, here is the LG monitor itself. And one of the features of that is this screen is tiltable. So you can tilt it to a higher angle if you like. And the stand here, if you can see at the bottom here, it's pretty nice. It's a glossy, shiny finish. And if you turn to the back, it's also very nice with the LG logo, ventilation, and of course all gloss black finish. With the LG logo right there, and ventilation. And this monitor is still pretty thin, and if you flip it down here, on the bottom of the screen, you'll see here you have a VGA and a DVI connection, and you can switch between those two. And over there, you can see there is the power outlet or inlet. So now let's go over some of the buttons and what they do on the monitor. Now, to turn the monitor on, you can see that there, right under there is the power button. And when it turns on, it should glow blue with, yep, the screen coming up shortly. There you go. And if you look over here, there are some of the settings for the monitor. Of course, there's the auto set button to adjust everything to the screen size, to select a source one, to select like whether you're running through VGA or DVI, or you can switch back in between the two. And here is the F engine, where you can access the presets of a monitor, the menu, and the easy zooming, which you also need to install the drivers for. Now, if you zoom out here, I'll try to show you how the presets are, but I'm not sure if you can really see it though. Hold on. Yeah. Alright, so if you go through and zoom in like there, you have these modes. You have normal, you have user, which is brighter, text, text. And then if you look on the bottom there, you'll see a slight difference in the color there. See how one side is darker than the other here? So this side is the text side, and this side is the normal side. So yeah, let's go through that again. So there's normal, there's user, there's text, and there's movie, which is the contrast you can see is a lot darker than the normal one. Now I have here War of the Worlds playing on the monitor, and I've set it to movie mode. As you'll notice a difference, the contrast, you know, goes all the way up, and the brightness is up too. So, and it makes for a pretty nice picture. So yeah, here's short clips of it. As you can see, some of the details pretty nice here.
No one would have believed in the early years of the 21st century that our world was being watched by intelligences greater than our own. That as men busied themselves about their various concerns, they observed and studied. The way a man with a microscope might scrutinize the creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. With infinite complacency, men went to and fro about the globe, confident of our empire over this world. Yet, across the gulf of space, intellects...
So in conclusion, this LG monitor, it's a very good monitor, and if you can find it for a good price, such as around maybe $200 Canadian, then it's a good deal. Get it. I recommend it. So yeah, thanks for watching, and see you next time.